My name is Lukas von Stockhausen, and I'm Senior Product Manager for Static Application Security Testing here at Fortify. Today, I would like to show you a new feature which we release in our Static Code Analyzer SCA release 20.2. This feature is speed dial. Before we kick off the presentation, let me very quickly show you here a demo which I'm going to start off right now, and you will see here the first step. All FPRs going to be deleted, and then while we go through the presentation, they will be recreated. Speed dial. The idea behind speed dial is that in different phases of the development of an application, you have different time requirements in order for a scan to fulfill, as well as different requirements in terms of the depth of a scan. In the beginning of an application, when you only work on a few files or while you're heavily developing, you want to have very, very quick results, whereas the depth of the scan is potentially, even because the application is not fully available yet, less important. The main important part is that you want to have a very, very immediate feedback. Whereas if you're getting closer to the release or on a scheduled basis, you want to see the full picture in terms of security of your application which you are developing. The way for us to fulfill or help with that is speed dial. Speed dial will be released in 20.2 as a technical preview. What we build on in 20.2 are the first two levels of speed dial, level 1 and 2. In level 1, we reduced the analysis by actually disabling most analyzers and really make sure that we get a very, very quick result by still giving certain issues to the developer so that he or she can very quickly get these results, for example, during a commit, and is able to quickly, while she's still in, or he's still in context, while the developer is still in context of the what he was programming, can very quickly fix those issues. This will be gradually increased up to level 4, where level 4 is going to be more or less a full scan. So you see here on this little chart on the lower side how we actually think these scans could be used during a commit of some files. You can actually use P1, which should give you a very, very quick results, so that we can actually give these issues back to the developer very quickly. For a pipeline where you actually build the application, you might want to get a little bit more detailed results. So depending on the size of the application and the complexity of the application, you can go through these different levels and see which level you need to use in order to fulfill your time requirements on the one side and your detailed result requirements on the other side. At certain points in time, and that is most likely out of the pipeline, unless you have a small app and get a quick scan there, you might want to run a full scan where you see all the details which we are capable to find on this application. As I said before, this is a technical preview, and we have enabled level 1 and level 2 already. Level 3, 4, and 4 will be worked on during the release of 21.1. Level 5 will actually, the idea behind that one, and this is why this is in red here, is actually the plan to have experimental analyzers, which we are developing on, where we see massive or big time necessities in order to run these scans. We will enable those in level 5, this is something which is experimental and which might lead to that your scan is not going to end. But on certain applications, you might find very, very detailed results. So this is the overview. How to enable these different scan positions? Well, you see here that we have that we run a normal translation. It's not dependent for the translation, but then we can actually either run an absolute normal scan. We can give this parameter scan position, and you see here we have scan position 1, scan position 2, and scan position 3, 4, and 5 we will work on. You see here, for example, for a smaller code base, the time differences, and this is running in the background as well while we are going through this presentation here, but you can see that we find 329 results during the full scan. We only find 160 results, but in roughly half the time during a P1 scan. And we again find the full result set, but still in a reduced time frame. This is where you see this is just on a small application. If we go to a very small application, for example, you see that we almost have no time difference. And I'm really excited to see the results in a moment, which are running live here. But we see here again, we have three results found in the full scan. We have two in P1, and we have again three results in level 2. This is the more results found here are actually because in level 2 we have already enabled all analyzers again. The beauty about all this is, and this is while we are actually going back here and we see the results are finished, we have our FPRs back. The beauty about all this is you will find in your installation these property files. And with these property files, you can actually manipulate the details of these different scan levels. So you see here that in level 1, for example, we have disabled control flow, buffer, data flow, and null pointer. We have also worked a little bit on the depth of the scan with some parameters. In level 2, we have enabled all analyzers again, so nothing is disabled here. But we see that there are additional parameters. So expect more to come here. Well, let's have a look at the results quickly, right? If we go here and see for our very small code base, we see it is scanned in exactly the same time in all these three different levels. So in a very small code base, there is almost no difference. So if you're only scanning a few files, all this is not really bringing a benefit. But if we go to the slightly larger code base, right, we see here a reduction between the full scan and the P1 scan of, not exactly half, but quite a good reduction already. This time here, we see that the P2 was already roughly at the same time than the full scan. So in this size of an application, there is no big difference. But this is, as I said before, depending on the size and the complexity of the application. So this is something to test around where you find the best timing with the best results for your application. That concludes this demo on SpeedDial. As I said before, this is a technical preview, so expect additional changes, but we are highly interested in your feedback on this new feature of Fortify. Thank you and have a good day.